quite a few people, and I would say that I learned a lot in Ric and I on the editing, and it's just a lot of footage and a lot of great things. A lot of great things Dr. Frazier said, and that we didn't get to include. A lot of things that Dr. Mike Roberts said that we didn't get to include. But overall, I think it was a labor of love. Hopefully, you appreciated it, and I'm hopeful that it starts the conversation. I think we had some great points in it. I think we had gave the audience an opportunity to be entertained as well as have some action steps. So hopefully, you know, you take it, feel it, and communicate it and pass it on to people. And what I think what's most important in our past tonight is that we no longer continue to just talk about these issues, but we continue to take steps, regardless of whether they're baby steps or giant steps, but we have to continue to take steps toward those things that ultimately make us free as a people. So those are my thoughts about you as a writer and producer on the film. Right. Yes.
I know for me, I can't talk about the progress of our people without talking about ownership. So, you know, we talk about land ownership and leveraging our wealth and talents. I mean, we can say a whole lot about other groups and a lot of the oppression that we've dealt with, but we do have issues in our community we gotta deal with. We gotta look at them head on and stop looking to sugarcoat our way to the top or excuse our way to the top. You know, we spend a lot of time talking about immigrants that are coming here taking on jobs, but we need to focus on the immigrants coming here creating them. That's a very big thing that's happening because they come creative and we work for those individuals who then wind up owning our land and our assets and, you know, siphoning money out of our community. So for me, I think for many of the problems that we have in our community, ownership solves 80-90% of them. But we have to be prepared for that. I think one of the things we really have to understand as I close my piece is it really starts with our personal financial habits. It really starts with our cash management, how we spend our money, not over-consuming based on the income or the cash that we're generating. That is a huge, huge problem. And, you know, we go into this mode of trying to show up to each other for no reason whatsoever. Like we're competing with each other for no reason. We're competing instead of collaborating. It doesn't make sense. So our financial habits are the things that hold us back. I always say that you gotta make your master fund your freedom. We're working for people that are giving us these high wages. We're fighting for the jobs, but then we take that same money to contribute to our own oppression. Because we're not taking it and saying, you know what, this money is the exact same money that I'm looking for out of an investor to start my business. This is the exact same money that's coming to us by way of paycheck. We look at our paycheck as lifestyle money, and then we look at the saviors as our investment money. So it really starts with issues in ourselves and how we manage our finances.
Thank you, Derek.
This is so good. I love this. You guys look great. Thanks, George, for putting this. The movie, I think, is great. I was excited to be a part of it. Really excited because I think that we are starting the conversation. And I think that a lot of people, and you guys are represented here, are showing that, you know what, I do care about my financial destiny. I care about my children's financial destiny. And you're obviously here because you want to make sure that you begin to implement wealth strategies that will create real generational wealth. I think the fact that we're even talking about it is definitely advancement because, you know, we've been on survival mode for so long. And so I just really want to commend you guys for investing in yourselves this weekend and being here. And then, of course, you know, when you get home, take that action step to say, okay, what's my 6-month plan? What's my 1-year plan? What's my 5-year plan? And really start looking at developing those wealth strategies.